الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين صلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين الغر الميامين المنتجبين المكرمين سيما بقية الله في الأرضين روحی و ارواح العالمین لتراب مقدمہ الفدا اما بعد فقد قال امیر المؤمنین علی ابن ابی طالب علیہ الصلاۃ والسلام کونوا للظالم خصما وللمظلوم عونا صلوا علی محمد و آل محمد On the day of the Shahada, the martyrdom of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa salam, it's such a great gathering today, alhamdulillah. And not just here today, wherever you see in the whole world, and if I say in the whole universe, even the angels are commemorating the Shahadat of Amir al-Mu'mineen. In the whole world, all the followers of Ahlul Bayt, the Shias of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa salam, and not just Shias of Amir al-Mu'mineen, the followers of, the lovers of Ahlul Bayt, it does not matter what school of thought they belong to, they are commemorating the Shahadat of Amir al-Mu'mineen today. Because the personality of Amir al-Mu'mineen is not just for Shias, is not just for Muslims, it's beyond that. To understand the personality of Amir al-Mu'mineen, it's not possible for human beings to know what Ali ibn Abi Talib was, what the personality of Ali ibn Abi Talib was, what the attributes of Amir al-Mu'mineen were, what the qualities of Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib were. If the personality of Amir al-Mu'mineen was defined, it was just true either by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. Different mufassirin from different school of thought, they have said that in Quran itself, out of 6,666 verses of Holy Quran, just 1,000 verses were for Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically in Quran was telling us what Ali ibn Abi Talib was. And if you look at the ahadith, the sayings of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, starting from the first day till Prophet Rasulullah departed from this world, all his life he was telling us fazails and attributes of Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi wa sallam. In one of the hadith, Prophet says, Al-Haqqu ma Aliyyin wa aliyun ma'al haq. And then Prophet says, yadurul haqqu haythu ma dar. Ali is with haq, with truth, and haq is with Ali ibn Abi Talib. And then Prophet does not say that wherever haq goes, Ali follows haq. Prophet says, wherever Ali goes, haq follows Ali ibn Abi Talib. Fazails of Amir al-Mu'mineen, it's not possible. In one of the hadith, Rasulullah said, man ahabba yanzur adama fi ilmihi, man nuhan fi khashiyatihi, wa ibrahima fi khullatihi, wa yahya fi zuhdihi, wa musa fi kamalihi,
وعيسى في خلته ويوسف في جماله فلينظر الى وجه علي بن ابي طالب. If someone wants to see علم, knowledge of حضرت آدم, if someone wants to see تقوى of حضرت نوح, if someone wants to see the عبادت of يحيى, if someone is going to see the beauty of يوسف, the كمال, the virtues of حضرت موسى, if someone is going to see the qualities of عيسى, just look at the face of علي بن ابي طالب, you'll see all the attributes in just one personality, علي بن ابي طالب. We know that to look at Kaaba, an-nazru ila al-Kaaba ibadah. To look at Kaaba is your worship, it's your prayer, you get rewards, you get hasanat if you look at Kaaba. An-nazru ila al-mushaf ibadah. If you look at Quran, you get rewards, you get sawab, you get hasanat. It's ibadat, it's your worship. And there's no other personality on the whole, in the whole universe, on any planet, that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that if you look at anyone's personality, space is ibadah besides Ali ibn Abi Talib. Prophet said that our nazru ila wajh Ali ibn Abi Talib ibadah. And not just that, not just to see and to look at the face of Ali ibn Abi Talib ibadah, al hubbu Ali ibn Abi Talib ibadah, al zikru Ali ibn Abi Talib ibadah. So there's no other personality besides Amir al-Mu'mineen, and there are reasons behind it. And we recite the fadail, the attributes of Ali ibn Abi Talib. There are reasons behind it. If you look into the history, and not just the history of the Murakheen who have mentioned, the historians who have mentioned in the Shia books, even the books of Ahl al-Sunnah, our brothers, different school of thought, if you look in the Hadith book, in their history book, they said there was no other besides Ali ibn Abi Talib who was with Rasulullah from the day one till Prophet has departed. There was no other besides Ali ibn Abi Talib. There are a lot of people, they claim that they were most sincere towards Islam, but people know that their most of their life, even 40 years, 50 years, 30 years was life, was worshipping idols. They were not Muslims, but Ali ibn Abi Talib, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has arranged that Ali came in Kaaba, Ali, and Ali was murdered in Masjid al-Kufa. There was a reason behind it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has arranged itself. And that's the reason that the first da'wat, the first invitation, the da'wat is al-ashira, when Prophet said that who is the one who's going to help me in preaching Islam, there was no one besides Ali ibn Abi Talib. Amir al-Mu'mineen at the age of 10 or 12 years of age, Amir al-Mu'mineen stood up, Ya Rasulullah, Ana Ya Rasulullah, I'm the one who's going to help you. I'm the one who's going to help you. And not on this occasion, not just on this occasion, on many other occasions, Prophet Rasulullah said, Ya Ali, Anta Minni, Wa Ana Minka. Ya Ali, Anta Akhi, Wa Wasi, Wa Khalifati Min Ba'di. And Da'wat al-Ashir Ali ibn Abi Talib announced that, Ya Rasulullah, I am the one who will be with you all that time. And Ali ibn Abi Talib stood by it. He proved it. If you look at the battles that Islam has fought, and let me clear one more thing here, that when we say Islam, now it's our responsibility, especially people living in the Western world, it is the responsibility to introduce the real face of Islam. The real face of Islam, what people are propagating, that's not Islam. If you want to understand Islam, come to the door of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Come to the home of Ahlul Bayt alayhimu salatu wa salam. You'll see the real face of Islam. And nowadays when you see that there are a lot of terrorism is going on in the whole world, nobody's safe right now. We condemn all the terrorism, no matter where it is happening. And we are the victims of terrorism. Not just today, the first terrorism happened on the day when Rasulullah has departed. If Ali ibn Abi Talib would have given his place, the place which belonged to Ali ibn Abi Talib, the world would be different today. It would have been different today. Terrorism. It happened on different occasions in Karbala. The history repeated itself. And it is even happening today. Look around the world. The followers of Ahlul Bayt, they belong to Shia school of thought or Sunni school of thought. The followers, the lovers of Ahlul Bayt are being killed today. Ibn Muljim was not in just 40th Hijrah. Ibn Muljim even exists today. The Ibn Muljim of today's time, we have to recognize that person. We have to recognize that school of thought and we have to condemn that. Because the Shias of Ahlul Bayt are the peaceful nation. And we have proved that. It's not that we're just talking for the sake of talking. Look at our history, 1400 years. We faced terrorism. We gave our lives. Our youth, our youngsters, our older people, our women. But we never lost our faith. We never stepped behind even an inch from the school of thought, from the teachings of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wassalam. Kunu, and this is from the will of Amir al-Mu'mineen. After the 19th, the night of 19th, but Amir al-Mu'mineen has given his will to Imam Hassan alayhi salatu wassalam. This is the part of that. And this is not just, it wasn't just for Imam Hassan alayhi salatu wassalam. It is for all Shia, it is for all Muslims, and it is for all human beings. It has no boundaries, it has no limits. Amir al-Mu'mineen has said, and even today, a lot of people, the Muslims and even non-Muslims, are doing research on Nahj al-Balagha, the sayings of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Because it has depth in it. The Nahj al-Balagha is not just for Shias, not just for believers of Amir al-Mu'mineen, it is for humanity. And if people would have gone to the right book, the book of Allah, sayings of